Hello gang, welcome back to the online art room. So for today, the first thing that you're going to need is just an eraser and a pencil. And if your pencil's already got the eraser, you are good to go. What we're gonna do first is draw a circle on our paper. And you wanna think about your placement of your circle. Probably a little bit on the lower end of the page, not too much in the middle because we've got lots of space to fill up here. So as you draw your circle, don't worry so much about it being a perfect circle because in fact, if it's not perfect, it's better because it shows that you did it and it wasn't just done by a computer. So after you get your circle on there, then you're going to want to think about basically doing a much larger circle around it, but starting at the base. It's going to be kind of an unfinished, funky circle. So have that in mind here. And you're going to start circle right about here. You're going to dip down, but then you're going to come back up and this is where the bigger circle goes around. And I like to pick up my pencil and not finish this part, but I'll go back here on the other side of the smaller circle and then just connect those two there. Okay? Remember, if you ever have any extra marks, use that magic eraser and just get rid of that spot. Alright? And just fix it up as best you can. Light pencil is key, right? Alright. So we're ready to move on. Now what you want to do is think of a funny looking rainbow. Now, normally rainbows are kind of on, let me see here if I pull out another blank paper. You think of a rainbow as more like this, right? Well, today we're going to make it first curve up and around, kind of closer to that. Right here, going up, and then come up to the top of your rainbow, come back down, connect it there. Okay. So, I noticed mine is a little off-center, so I'm actually going to do a quick fix there. So, that's perfect, because remember, that's what erasers are for. If you want to fix it, if you don't like how it first came out, then go ahead and try it again. I'm trying to keep mine more on the center of my paper. Alright, so, come out, go up, and around. There we go. Now, that's really good. I definitely think it's better, but it's too tall. I want to leave a little bit more space. So, here we go again. And maybe the third time's the charm. We shall see. Alright, that looks a little better. Not perfect, and that is okay. So, now I'm going to create, if you figured out what we're making, the ears to my bunny. So, when I do my ears, I could think of more of like a curved triangle. Or I can also go dip down, come back, and go together. Kind of like a leaf. Oh my goodness, these are huge ears. That's okay. And fill up my page here. Whoop, there we go. Okay. So this line here, I'm actually going to erase this time. And then replace that area with the eyes of my bunny. Okay. So the eyes are going to go, they're kind of like, upside down triangles, but with a little more curve to them, and if you want a cute little bunny, just put them like this. Okay, starting to look a little more bunny-ish. Now, once I add my nose, which is just going to be a V into my circle here, and bring it down. You do it that way, or if you don't really like that, you can bring it a little bit more straight and then come off, which I personally prefer. Alright, so that's the first step of our bunny, and we'll come back and continue the rest of our picture in a little bit.